There's a whole world of possibilities out there. And with mass spectrometry, I truly believe we can answer a lot of the questions.
Some of what we do almost seems like magic. We never get to see, touch, or feel a protein, but we can measure them and we can monitor them and we can understand their molecular functions and we can try to understand how that molecular function relates to the disease and causes the disease. And so the motivation there was like, there's a problem, something's broken, and how do we fix it?
Because we work in the sphere of Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, and ALS, we're always looking for things that are really, really hard to find. And so using the new instrumentation, that's just going to shake things up for us. Who knows, we might find new targets.
My name is Blaine Roberts, and I have a PhD in biochemistry and biophysics. The main focus and goal of our lab is to develop new tools to move the needle on our ability to diagnose and treat these diseases. And what we're able to do now with like something like the neofleX and other imaging modalities is we can actually measure molecules we could never see before. So like individual lipids, drugs, we can see how they're distributed. Do they go to an individual cell type, right? Or do they hit all cells? Do they accumulate in all cells? Nowadays, we can go past that descriptive, just morphological look of the cells that are there to the actual molecules that drive the neurotransmission and the storage and passage of information.
So I know my parents do a lot of research to try and find like cures for Alzheimer's, Parkinson's. So they work in a lab all day looking at brain tissue.
Our first, Abby, she has come in and she has worked in the lab. Lance has also come in and worked in the lab.
It's always a challenge to not bring work home with you. It's a little bit special because Anne and I work together, so then of course we do talk about work at home. One of the coolest things is that there are blood-based tests and there are therapies that are being approved for Alzheimer's disease, so that space is growing. The development of the disease in the brain occurs for about 20 to 30 years before symptom onset. So that's been the big thing. I think looking forward, what we're really hopeful for is that that's going to translate to the Parkinson's space too. And so like our research that's funded through the Michael J. Fox Foundation is trying to move the needle there and help with the diagnosis and also treatment of Parkinson's disease. What I would like to see spatial proteomics bring to the world is a world where we can do this on the near full proteome. So instead of doing one target, we're now doing 1,000 and get a much more complete view and potentially in a more automated way. I think that would be a great advance for spatial proteomics.